me as I dance under the spotlight. Listen to the people screaming, I'm more and more, 'cause I create the feeling that keep them coming back. Yeah, I create the feeling that keep them coming back. So captivating when I get it on the floor. Know you've been patiently waiting, I know you need me, I can feel it. I'm a beast, I'm an animal, I'm that monster in the mirror. The headliner, finisher, I'm the closer, winner. Best when under pressure, with seconds left for sure.
It's only like 10:30 in the morning, and you can tell we're a bad influence on Carolyn already because we've already got her drinking beer.
It's tasty.
And where are we? We're in the Vancouver airport on our way to Hong Kong and then Thailand. So yeah, this is a good start to a good trip.
Excellent start.
Too much drink and we're late for our flight. We gotta go. It's like 5 o'clock in the morning for us. We've been up for a good 24 hours. I've had like zero sleep.
Yeah, kind of cranky. I'm gonna admit it.
14 hour flight. And we only got like 2 hour flight left to go. Woohoo!
Yay, we're almost there.
It's March 23rd, 2010, and the Canadian Travel Mongers are off to Thailand. We will arrive in Bangkok at 11 p.m., and we have arranged a ride to take us directly to the hotel, New Siam Riverside. After breakfast at the hotel, we begin our 2-week action-packed adventure and walked about a block up the river to a water taxi stand. I knew from reading ahead of time that this would be a good way to travel to sites nearby. We bought a multi-pass ticket for 150 baht, about $5, and boarded the taxi to go up to the Grand Palace. From the water taxi, it was a short walk to the Grand Palace. It was cheapest and safest to hire a private guide once we were inside the palace gates.